Hello everybody, this is Nuttles Commander with this week's Pokemon of the Week, and this is on August the 3rd, 2010. And this week's Pokemon of the Week was requested by username Grass Squid, and it was requested on the last episode, so if you know who you obviously know who you are, so you'll know what Pokemon I'm doing this week. You guys probably already know anyway because of the thumbnail. So this week's Pokemon of the Week is Torterra. And Torterra is the continent Pokemon. It came in the Sinnoh region and is the final evolution of Turtwig, which is one of the grass starter Pokemon from Sinnoh. And it is a grass ground type. And the stats are as follows. HP is base 95. Attack is base 109. Base defense is 105. Base special attack is 75. Base special defense is 85. And base speed is 56. So that's all the details gone over. And its weaknesses actually are fire, ice, which is a 4x weakness, flying, and bug. So those are the weaknesses. So now for my thoughts on Torterra. Torterra is awesome. I like Torterra very, very much. I think he is one of the best Pokemon that ever came about. I like all of the starters really, but Torterra is definitely one of my favourite. I might even go as far as to say he might be my third favourite, but I'm not sure. You know, not very good at comparing Pokemon in terms of liking, unless I go into the details like our Pokemon comparison. So, move pool wise, for physical move pool there's quite a lot, but I'll go over the ones that are of note. As level up moves, it gets Wood Hammer through a move teacher, not tutor, teacher, which is helpful because Wood Hammer is one of the best grass type moves in the game. It's also physical, which goes great with his attack stat. It also learns how to use Earthquake, which is always good for Pokemon with high attack power. It learns Crunch, which is great for coverage. And as for TM and HM moves, it does learn, hang on, let me find a move. I've already mentioned Earthquake, it gets that through TM as well. It also learns Stone Edge, which is really useful. Yeah, because it's always used for same reasons as Earthquake, really. It also covers those nasty ice types that Torterra is probably going to be coming across in battle. It also learns Rock Slide if you don't like Stone Edge's accuracy, but to be honest, Stone Edge and Rock Slide is like a 10% difference, so, you know, it's not really a huge difference. But what else does it learn that's physical? As for Move Tutor, it gets three notable moves. Two are pretty good, one is not so good. The one that's not so good is Outrage. Outrage, as I said before, is you can give it to him, and it does work. But if you ask me, Outrage is best suited to dragons, because the downside isn't worth it. Not to mention, Seed Bomb, which is the next move, is just as strong, and it's only super effective on dragons, you know, which you can, you know, probably do for neutral damage anyway. It's just not worth it, you know. If you ask me, Outrage is only good for dragons. It also learns Iron Head, which is useful. It covers those steel types, you know, and also has a pretty good flinch rate. It can be used on rock types, but once again, not really worth it because you could just go with a Wood Hammer or a Seed Bomb. As for the last move, it's Superpower. Now this is just a good move in general, you know, unless you don't like the attack and defense drop you get from Superpower. If it was me building up one of these, I probably would not give it to Superpower because it limits its attack and defense, and those are one of its best stats going, really, in general. So, you know, you can give it to him if you want to, but it's not. You can afford to leave it if you want. As for egg moves, it learns Superpower through that as well. But one really great thing about Torterra was Heart Gold and Soul Silver. It gives them the ability to learn Stockpile, right, and Swallow, and Spit Up. Now, Spit Up isn't really worth it because it's a special attack, and, you know, Torterra's power lies in his attack stat. You can give build him up to be a special attacker, but once again, Spit Up isn't really that useful because there's just better options. But as for the other two, now those really do get my attention. Stockpile is excellent because in Heart Gold Soul Silver or all 4th generation games, it boosts the defense and special defense stats. And what this does is make Torterra more bulky than he originally is. His special defense goes to 295 and his defense goes to 339. The special defense is okay, but after a stockpile, you're going to be packing some serious bulk on this thing. And the only thing that's really going to hurt it a lot is moves like Fire Blast or Blizzard. Stuff like that is the only moves that are going to seriously hurt it. You know, or even Overheat or stuff like that. Yeah, but Ice type move are going to do the most damage, and the best Ice type move is Blizzard. So I doubt it would survive a Blizzard after one stockpile. It may do it after two, probably will after three. Depends what you're carrying, really. If you're carrying a Yanchi Berry, then you'll most likely survive one anyway. But just for good measure, I would recommend you may maximize the special defense stat if running a stockpile set. But as for Swallow is alright. But I'll explain why after. Swallow restores a lot of HP, and it depends on how many stockpiles you've got. But you've got to keep in mind that you lose the stockpile effects, like the defense and special defense. You're going to lose those if you use Swallow. But there isn't actually much need for that, because moving up to the support list, you can actually teach it how to use Synthesis. And what this is basically, if the weather is normal, you can give it, it will restore half HP. If the weather is hail or sandstorm, it'll only do 25%. It's basically moonlight. It's the best way of putting it. It's basically just like moonlight. You know, I don't know how I know it's at the best in the sun. So I think in the sun, it heals through about 75%. But in general, it'll do 50%, which is just like recover. So if you want my advice, give it Synthesis and not Swallow, because Synthesis is a pretty good move. Unless you're running a Sandstorm team, of course. Yeah, which brings me to another support move that is really useful. And that would be Leech Seed. It also learns Leech Seed, which is a very useful move because you're sapping your opponent's strength while recovering your own. It's one of those moves that, you know, gives you a bit of offense and defense going at the same time. So yeah, that's really good. Now, as for special attacking mode, sadly it's quite limited. I know you can build it up to be a special attacker, maybe even a choice specs. In fact, I recently saw a video uploaded by Dinaman12 showing you a choice specs Torterra, and you know, he says it works really well, and you know, I'm sure it does. You know, if he's used it, then he must know what he's talking about. And so I'll go over some of the special attacking moves. Oh, one thing I should mention though is it can learn Reflect and Light Screen. So if you want some team support, you can go for that. And it also learns Toxic and Roar, which is handy in general. So back to special attacks, it learns Giga Drain, which is, I suppose, is useful. But surprisingly, its most powerful move is Leaf Storm. Well, unless you count Frenzy Plant, but I don't like Frenzy Plant because of the downside. But Leaf Storm is really good because it's just pretty powerful. It gets hidden power, which is always good, you know. But it also learns Energy Ball if you don't like Leaf Storm's effect. It also gets Grass Knot, you know, and it also learns Earth Power, which is a good move, that is a good choice to have, but, you know, that's really it though, sadly. It is quite limited on the special move pool, but it is good that it does learn Hidden Power. So it is that way, it's got a trick up its sleeve. Right, I've gone for quite long, so I'm going to have to end the video here. So thank you all for watching. If you wish to post a response telling me your thoughts on Torterra, be my guest. And or in general, just leave a comment below. So thank you all for watching and goodbye.